Every single politician at some point had zero power politically, and an election took place, and they had power. There's a transfer of power from you all to them, to us, which makes you the greater magistrate. So I'm going to ask you a couple questions to bring this into view. How was America founded?
Revolution.
It was by giving King George a giant FU through a concept known as nullification. Where we the people said no, hell no, no more. Probably in that order. And they did not petition King George for independence. They declared independence. Declared it. So the first mistake that we make when we go to these local meetings is we petition someone who is our servant. We beg and grovel for records. You don't beg the help. The king doesn't beg the jester. You go in there and you proclaim, you declare. And if you're not proclaiming and you're not declaring, you've already lost. You're not getting rid of the machines in Maryland if you can't take back your local meeting. Let's start there. You're not taking back anything if someone's telling you get 2 minutes or 3 minutes to talk. If you don't get back your time, you've already lost. We don't even know how to fight the battle. We don't know how to dust off the civil rights manual of the 1960s when people were actually fighting for equality, getting sprayed by water cannons, locking arms. That's what it's going to take. And if you don't see it that way, you don't see the problem for what it is. This issue is worth being arrested over. This issue is worth dying for. And this isn't about Trump. This isn't about 4 years. I'm not doing this for a four-year lease on sanity. I'm doing this because I want generational security for my daughter, and Lord willing, my granddaughter, to cast a vote that matters. And there's no statute of limitations for doing the right thing. So many of you are asking the wrong questions. Even now, you're asking the wrong questions. Because you're smart. You're thinking, well, Dave, if I go to that meeting, the sheriff's got a monopoly on force. Law enforcement has a badge. They have guns. Can you think of one historical example ever where you were to legislate our way out of tyranny? It's never happened. It never will happen. So your superpower is your numbers. And right now, we have not shown our numbers. J6, we got a lot of people that microanalyze this. They think, well, I didn't go in, so I think I'm safe. Mm-hmm. I didn't do this, so I think I'm going to be okay. The only thing, and I want you to hear this loud and clear, the only thing that the J6ers did wrong is that there should have been 80 million people there, not 1 million. And two, they should have never left until we fix the problem. That's the only thing. And all the salacious footage that you saw on TV, all of the most disgusting things that you saw weren't even done by the J6ers. They were done by Fed informants that were never arrested. And some unwitting soul was standing right next to them, and they were taken away. Can you finally see? So my ask for you all, the reason why I'm here tonight, the reason I'm going to Michigan tomorrow, the reason I'm going to Amarillo next week, the reason I'm going to five counties in California, the reason why I'll do this until all my hair falls out. I actually had brown hair 4 years ago. Four years ago, I had brown hair. I had two abs. Now I've got a gut. I don't care. Those jackets, I'm wearing them out. Someone saw this film, they sent me this jacket. Now I'm wearing this every day until it wears out. If you saw in the film, there's paper in between this. My wife put hot glue in between this right here. Now they work. We fix, we duct tape everything, and we're relentless until we fix the problem. But the problem is not you don't have the right lawsuit. The problem is not we don't have the right pile of fraud. The problem is that we haven't found, I'm about to say something, anatomically incorrect. We haven't found our balls.
Right. Yeah.
We haven't shown up together and scaled what you all just did and got your light bulb on. You got your light bulb on tonight. How hard was that? You came here to watch a movie because you felt safe. Can this same group go to a meeting 2 weeks from now or a week from now and do the same thing? You don't have to wait. Show up. And there's pragmatic things that you can do. Number one, you can request that this is put on an agenda for hours. How long? As long as you need to tell the story. Number two, your commission, your administrators, don't get to dictate the terms of your public confidence. Meaning, you bring it to them. You tell them what they need to hear. You don't need to hear from another ESNS vendor that's going to lie through their teeth. You bring the experts to them. Now, if they won't do it, and they probably won't, then you're left with public comment, but at least you try. Now you've got to reclaim your time. You got to get away from 2-3 minutes and get to whatever amount of time you're entitled to, which is as much time as you need. There's no rule, there's no statute that says it's got to be 3 minutes. The chairperson can change the time right then and there. It's completely arbitrary. Bring that to their attention. You don't have to yield your time. You don't have to carve up your time 3 minutes and you talk for 3 minutes. You talk for 3 minutes because if you do that, you're going to look like bumbling monkeys. There's no way that you can articulate what's in this film in 3 minutes. Do you understand that? So these are the victories that we have to have. Now, what I can tell you right now is, and I said this before we started, everyone's still waiting for the version of the plan where there's no risk. They're waiting for the plan where I can say 100% we're going to win if you do what I say tonight. I'm not making those guarantees. What I'm signing you up for is the cross. I'm signing you up for persecution. I'm signing up for the Gideon 300. And the Gideon 300 are warriors ready to die for this. And if you're worried about daycare for your kid, if you're worried about your mom, if you're worried about something you got to do, maybe this isn't for you. Maybe you're not one of the Gideon 300. That's fine. But for the men out there, for the guys that like to talk tough, ones that have your bumper stickers on your car about we the people, that you're part of the Constitution Club. I'm a John Bercher. I'm a Tea Partier. Empty talk if you're not showing up to the gap to interpose between the victims and the tyrants. So I'm hereby forfeiting, canceling, nullifying your bitching and moaning card if you don't take whatever your concerns are to the gap and you start bringing people with you. It doesn't have to be 300. It could be 500, it could be 1,000. What's the population in Frederick County? 260,000 people. You think we can find more than 300 people to show up to a meeting in an air-conditioned building? People act like I'm recruiting you for like double shifts at the coal mine, or that you're storming the beaches in Normandy. You're going to an air-conditioned building in front of 3 to 5 feckless, idiotic politicians. And the reason why we're not taking back control of the time and everything else is because we don't have the numbers. So hear me, if I come there and I have all the answers because I made a documentary, or Kate comes because she's got all the answers, she knows Maryland better than I do, they will look at her and you with contempt. It's not about good faith discourse. It's not about rational discourse. It's about the mob. There's only two ways you're going to get their attention. Number one, through revelation. You all, for the most part, came here tonight because you see clearly, or more clearly than most. Don't congratulate yourself. It's not because you're smarter. It's not because I'm smarter. It's not because we went to the right schools. It's because God whispered to you at some point over the past 4 years. He whispered to your heart and your mind, and you listened. That's it. There are a bunch of sheep out there that haven't gotten the whisper yet, which means God loves you all enough to see you as shepherds. So what makes this happen? You saw in the film this idea of national repentance. I hope you can just walk past that. It's the most important thing. It's the most important thing. Because some of you are still stumbling over yourselves thinking that it's up to me. I've got to have my perfect argument. I've got to have my talking points. I've got to have everything put together. No, you don't. You can be an unemployed person that hates election law, like myself, and be consumed and possessed by this because God gave you revelation. It's that simple. So, about a year ago this time, a pastor by the name of Eon Pea came to my home. And even though I don't let you know that I'm down, I have my moments where I don't want to get out of bed. I don't want to get out of bed. I don't want to leave my kids. I don't want to leave my family. IRS sent me a bill before Christmas because of this film for tens of thousands of dollars. We get death threats. We got debanked. They seized every dime that was associated with this film. DVD packaging company canceled this, processed it, canceled this. Our biggest promotional partner gave up us on the day of the launch. And everyone that I care about, whether it's Peter Benegger, who's just arrested last week, and I'm sitting there, why am I still here talking with you? Well, that's what I'm doing, but here's the deal. God has ordained this for me to be a place marker, to tell people, I won't be here next year. If we don't win, I'll be with everyone else. You need to know that. I'm okay with that. It is what it is. Question is, have you all turned your scalpel this way? Not to Mike Lindell, not to USA, not to all the groups out there. Have you personally turned the scalpel towards yourself and said, what will I do? In my home county, for all of you that are so hopeless, well, what good will it do? I show up to my county commission meetings when I'm in town, in the poorest county in the country, and I show up to the county commission meetings by myself. And I punch in my time card, and I go in there, and the commission knows who I am. They hate me. The county attorney gets out his phone. He's got the sheriff on speed dial. And as soon as I start talking, if I go over, they show up, they bring the deputies, and they physically remove me. That's my commitment. I don't need the 300, because I'm a warrior. I've counted the cost. Now, if everyone showed up with me, that wouldn't happen. I'd have some type of jubilee in Doniana County, New Mexico. I'm not going to have that. But you got to keep it loose. You got to be battle-hardened. And what I'm asking you all tonight is consider practicing civil rights. Practicing showing up to a meeting. If you're not ready to talk, sit there and learn something. If you're not ready to stand up front, stand next to the person talking. Can you do that? And just start the process. And you might just get a Jenga block to pull out in your county or an adjacent county or somewhere else. You pull out three or four blocks in Maryland, the whole thing falls over. And it will fall over. Everything will fall over. So back to my pastor friend. Came over, Ion Pea, Romanian, thick accent. And he could tell I was down because I've had enough. And he said, Professor Clements, I lived under Romanian communism. Any of y'all know who Richard Rohrbrand is? Founder of Voice of the Martyrs. Lived underground in a cell that was 3 paces by 3 paces, basically smaller, probably half the size of the stage, for 3 years. That's where he lived. Can you imagine that? Well, he only lived in that country. And in 1989, he says, I remember the armed soldiers with their guns at the town square. I remember the armored vehicles. And I was there when communism fell in one day. The Spirit of the Lord moved through the people. What did they get? Revelation. That's what they got. All of a sudden, people could see their sin, their culpability. And right now, you've got so many commissioners, so many rhinos, so many feckless politicians. They can't see. They can't see, folks, unless they have revelation. So when I talk about national repentance, that's a must. God's not going to change his conditions. I'm telling you that right now. If Trump holds out, it does not bode well for us. That's why I put this in the film. Trump's not calling me up, by the way. That means we have to keep asking for this. It was good enough for Abraham Lincoln. And what happens when you meet that condition? And it costs nothing. It's basically a 5-minute video on truth where he can say something very humble. You meet the condition, God moves from the throne room, from the throne. He walks to the courtroom of heaven, and he sits down in the judgment seat. And he's got a gavel, and he renders a verdict. And when the gavel comes down, revelation for tens of millions, if not hundreds of millions of people happens instantaneously. And that's when your clerk that you put on notice says, what have I done? That's when your doctor that jabbed a baby that died says, what have I done? Everything that you're heartbroken over, that's when you get justice. But you have to show up and put people on notice. You have to be the process servers of truth, showing up to these buildings, to these meetings that no one wants to go because they've already given up. That's not the point. Duty is ours, results are God's. And so the Gideon 300 go to battle in Frederick County, every county. We've got 3,147 counties. And my pledge to you tonight is I'm going to try to hit every state. But I can't get to all the counties. I look at this audience. How many counties in Maryland?
23.
24 jurisdictions. Can you take this film free and go to an adjacent county? Gather people while they're feeling safe, while their guard is down. Have them stand and honor our J6ers, like you all just did, and do the easiest light bulb moment there is. Sit down, two volunteers, here and here, one over there to be our sheriff's deputy, one person we're going to make fun of, and we're looking for two things. Number one, when I tell the person to sit down, do they do it? And if they sit down right away, we pause, and we correct. Number two, we're testing the audience that's there. Do they get up and stand with the other greater magistrate? If they don't, we pause, we rewind, we have everyone stand up together and let them see how easy this is. It's really easy. That's all it takes to start the process. Again, this does not mean you're done. So what do you demand? We'll end with this. Number one, I'm not here to tell you that your election administrators, your clerks, whatever the terminology is, have the legal authority to get rid of ESMS and get you a different machine. I'm not saying that. But who certifies the machine that you use? Does your Secretary of State come here and certify your black box? No. It's whoever your election administrator is. They and they alone certify a piece of paper that accompanies that tabulator. When they do that, they're saying, this machine, Frederick County, is trustworthy. After watching this, do you believe it? Then you have to make sure that that person knows, is put on notice, because they probably already do know. But you get it on the record. That means you show up to this meeting, and even if it's three people, you do what George Washington did, which is you use your smartphone and you record it, or it's going to be recorded, and you showcase the battle between you, the greater magistrate, and the defective tyrant. And you start scaling it. If you've got a conservative group, perhaps consider changing the name of your conservative group to Tea Party Frederick County, whatever, to ending with news at the end. Create your own news website. Consider yourself a newsman or a newswoman. And go to these meetings, record them, write a story, post them on social media. So when that clerk or administrator or canvassing board goes home, your encounter doesn't die as soon as people leave. It lives on. Because if that clerk or that canvassing board does not get a revelation, like Jesus showing up that night saying, you're a terrible human being, you've got to create something else, which is called the Jacob Marley effect. People here know your Dickens?
Yep.
Yeah.
Christmas Story? Was Scrooge a good guy?
No.
No, he wasn't. So he started hearing what?
Ghosts.
He heard those rattling chains of Jacob Marley. You all represent the rattling chains. You show up. When they go home, they go, this is the worst gig ever. This sucks. I showed up to be a commissioner because I wanted to practice a little insider training, change some zoning laws, favor my own business interests. That's the way it works, right? But they're not letting me do it. They keep talking about these election machines. And then you go home, like, how was your day, honey? As you know, the bride's sitting in bed, and the bride's on her phone ignoring him because he's worth ignoring because he doesn't understand the election was stolen. And she says, what's this? This is you at the commission meeting, and it's got 10,000 views. What is it about? Oh, it's you getting basically humiliated by the community, showing that you're a feckless scoundrel. And I'm not sure I want to be married to you anymore. That's how you create the chains of Jacob Marley. This is a campaign. This is not you go to one meeting and get it all done. This is welcome to the rest of your life. You get rid of the machines, praise God. Guess what you got to do now? You all have to count the ballots because no one else is going to do it. This is about us showing up and occupying what makes our country wonderful, which is self-governance. Instead of seeing this as a sentence, I have to go to a meeting, you should go and think, I'm going to make sure the school board never puts pornography in front of my children. I'm going to make sure that my town doesn't have another cannabis shop right here next to my house. I'm going to make sure that this happens and this happens. So your demand is withhold certification on that machine. And you can make that. It's legal to do so. Because your election code, just like every other election code out there, has an aspirational provision saying that your vote and the way that it is administered is a trust between the administration and you. It's a trust. And everyone thinks that the way that you find someone in violation of your code is through what? You got to catch someone hacking. You got to catch someone, you know, stuffing a ballot box. No. You can violate your election code by showing up, putting them on notice of all these deficiencies, and when they do zero investigation, guess what? That's a violation of Maryland's election code.
Right.
You're creating a legal peril. Some of you are wondering whether or not your politicians are bonded. This idea of bonds for the win. Well, I'm going to tell you right now, they don't have personal bonds. There's no skin in the game. They've got generalized bonds, which means you can bluff with that. It's not going to work. But what you can do is start sending letters to the insurance provider for the counties. Do you know about this? Defective process insurance provider? Do you know about this defective process insurance provider? You start paper trailing them because you've got a potential massive class action. There are so many things that you can do. The county attorneys, many of your machines aren't even certified. Why aren't they filing writs of mandamus against their own governor and own secretary of state for foisting this? The reason why they're not is because we haven't applied pressure. When you show up to these meetings, you're presenting opportunities to go to battle, and you can do it any which way that you can. You can think of, be creative, make it up. What do you have to lose? Nothing. Or everything. So if this seems radical to you all, it's not. If you think that I'm radical, I'm not. I had a great job, great career. Went to Google, everything looked really nice. And now I am bona fide crazy. And there's no difference except for I started to speak and go places and speak. That's all I do is speak truth wherever. But I want to make sure I go to a place where it matters. And when they take me, fine.